Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. So in today's video, I will be drawing this honorable personality, Mr. Ratan Tata, using graphite pencils. And then I'll be showing you the step-by-step process of my shading technique. And I'll also be sharing some tips which might help you improve your art. So hope you like this video, and if you do, just hit that like button. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel so you will get notified whenever we post a new video. So without further ado, let's get started. Starting with an eye, I'm first darkening the outlines and adding the first basic layer using 2B pencil, and I'm shading it with a very light hand. Carefully observe the reference photo and add the mid-tone using 4B pencil. Blending the layers with the synthetic brush. Now adding the darkest layer using 8B or 9B pencil. Make sure to observe your reference carefully. Wherever you see the darkest tone, you need to put some darker values using 8B or 9B over there. Now blending it with the dry brush. And I am adding the highlight using kneadable eraser. Now starting with the base layer around the eye using 2B pencil. I always use back and forth shading technique to get the consistent layer, and it helps smoothen things up whenever I blend the layer using the synthetic brush. So in case if you're wondering about what is happening around the eyebrows, I'm using the indenting method for that. So if you don't know what is indenting method, I'll be showing you in this video. Once I'm done with the mid-tone values using 4B, now I'm moving on with the darkest values. I'm using 8B or 9B pencil for this. Now I'm darkening the wrinkles around the eyes. So once we are done with that, we will start with the base layer. And now blend it with the dry brush. Now using a 4B pencil to add the darker tones between the wrinkles. For the better result, we need to shade each wrinkles individually. So observing the reference photo carefully and adding the shades accordingly. It is very important to match the values of the shades to get the realistic effect. Make sure that your lights are light enough and your dark tones are dark enough. That will help you get that contrast, which will give you that realistic look. After everything is done, I just blend it out with the synthetic brush and add the highlights using kneadable eraser or Tombow Mono Zero eraser or any hard tip eraser that you have. This shading process takes a lot of patience. It takes time, so don't lose hope. Even if you think that the shading that you're doing, it is not satisfying you, just keep working on it. Take your time, observe the reference carefully, and just make your strokes accordingly. I'm sure it will turn out good. Okay, so patience is the key. Just keep working on it, don't lose hope, and remember to have fun while you're drawing. This is supposed to make you feel better, not frustrated. Alright, once that is done, I am copying exact same steps for the right eye as well. I am starting with the base layer. After that, I add middle tones using 4B or 5B. And for darker tones, I use 8B and 9B. And for blending purpose, I use synthetic brush. For each layer, you have to blend it with the synthetic brush. And for the last layer, when you find that the values are correct, then you will use a kneadable eraser to add the highlights according to the reference. So in case if you are wondering about the material that I am using, I have listed all the materials that I have used for this drawing in the description. You can check that out, and it will also have the Amazon link to it, so you can check it out and buy it yourself if you want. But I am not saying that this is the exact same process that you need to follow to get the realistic effect, or this is the exact materials that you need for that. Just remember to have some decent materials so that you can work on it. If you are interested in watching more such sketching videos, we have a playlist called Sketching on our channel. It will now show up a pop-up card above the screen. You can click on it and watch all the sketching videos that we upload on this channel. And we also have other playlists as well. We have a crafting playlist, we have a watercolor painting playlist. So you can watch if you are interested. And make sure to like this video and hit the subscribe button if you like our efforts. Now moving on to the forehead skin. I'm starting with the base layer using H pencil. Now I'm using a 2B pencil for establishing the darker parts. So this is kind of like a foundation for our darker tones. This is not a final shade that I'll be doing. I'll be using 4B pencil and later on I'll be using 8B and 9B pencil to darken it. Now I'm establishing the wrinkles around the forehead. So according to the reference image, these wrinkles are not that visible. So I'm only using the light hand and not putting a lot of pressure on it. Now moving on to the indenting method that I have mentioned earlier in this video. I'm using here indenting stylus. You can also use any old non-working ballpoint pen and tip of your mechanical pencil for this. So I basically use this method for sketching hairs. So what you have to do is you just have to mark those indenting lines according to the direction of the hair. And when you add any shading on top of it, those indentation lines will remain white as it is. And that will give you that crisp white hairs that you see in the eyebrows. You just have to be careful that you are making those indentation lines as per the direction of the hair, because if you mess it up, then you cannot really erase those lines. Alright, moving on with the darker tones. आई एम यूजिंग 4B पेंसिल नाउ एंड आई एम डार्कनिंग दोज शेडोज दैट वी हैव एस्टेब्लिश्ड यूजिंग 2B पेंसिल बिफोर. अगेन मेक श्योर टू ऑब्जर्व द रेफरेंस इमेज केयरफुली. It is very important that you observe the reference image again and again. That will help you study those lines, study the tones, and compare the darker tones with the lighter tones to get the exact value that you need for the realistic effect. Now blending the layers with the dry brush. As you can see, I am darkening those wrinkles now. Now I am blending those wrinkles and those green textures that I have added using a blending stump. Okay, now I'm adding highlights using kneadable eraser around those wrinkles. And now using 8B pencil for darker tones. Now I'm adding the brightest highlights using Tombow Mono Zero eraser, or you can also use any hard tip eraser. Alright, moving on with the hairs. I have already added those indentation lines using the same method that I have shown you earlier in this video. And I have added those indentation lines as per the direction of the hair. So first I am adding the base layer using 2B pencil. And I am checking the reference image carefully, and wherever I find the lightest value, I am taking that value as a base layer and adding it onto the hair. Also, it is important to add those pencil strokes as per the direction of the hair. Otherwise, it will not give you the result that you want. Okay, now moving on to the darker tones. I'm using a 4B pencil over here and I'm adding those darker strokes by looking at the reference image. Okay, now I'm blending the layers, and after that I'll add the highlights using Tombow Mono Zero eraser. Thank you. Okay, now for other part of the hairs, I am using the same exact process. Okay, now moving on to the nose part. This is overall the same process that I have used before for the skin. That is the same process I'll be following for this. Now for lid, first adding the base layer using 2B pencil. Filling in the corner of the mouth with a darkest tone. And blending it with the blending stump. The same process is for the lower lips as well. I'm completing the rest of the skin with the same steps that I used for the forehead. According to the reference image, the clothing is almost pitch black, so I'm applying the base layer using 4B pencil. Now using a 8B pencil, I'm adding the darkest layer and then blending it with the synthetic brush. For necktie, first add these texture lines according to the reference image. Make sure to add these texture lines using darker pencils because we will be adding some layers on top of it. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you like this video, and if you do, then make sure to hit that like button. And also, if you want more such videos, then make sure to subscribe to our channel and hit that bell icon to get notified. So until the next video, I'll catch you guys later.